Well, folks, we're going to be starting in on the 69 Charger 12 revamp today. And to start things off, we're going to be pulling out this battery just to get a little bit of extra room to work around the engine. And then after that, we're going to be pulling all the shrouds off to check the trigger ignition system that rides against the flywheel, because those have been known to fail. And depending on whether it's good or not and how the wires are going to it, it's going to depict whether I'm going to have to convert this over to points ignition or not, which I just assume determined before we get the carburetor cleaned up, because without spark, there's no use doing that. So let's get this battery pulled out and then we can start pulling the engine apart. Alright, so I was able to get every bolt on this shroud loosened up, except for the back one over here, and I really don't want to break it, so I got my little propane torch here. We're going to give it a little bit of heat and see if we can get it to break free. Alright, got it to break free. It's not moving much, but it doesn't take much movement. So I'm just going to keep hitting this with penetrating oil and heating it up. We're going to see if we can get it to back out without snapping. Well, I was able to get it moving, like I said. Unfortunately, it did end up breaking, but not too big of a deal. It's on the back side, and all the other bolts are still in it, so it shouldn't have a problem. A little crusty in the shroud, not too bad overall. You can see it's rotted through a little bit on the inside, but compared to some of the ones I've had, I'm pretty happy with it. Just going to clean up some of the crusty stuff, wipe it down with some oil, and that'll be ready to go back on. And as for the trigger, wires are still there. The guy said it didn't have spark, but I'm going to check it myself anyways. I'll pull the plug out and wind it over with the starter and see what happens. And hopefully this still works. Unfortunately, they're very expensive. You can buy them new, but they're somewhere around $200, which is kind of ridiculous for what it is, which is why it's just cheaper to convert over to points anyways. So pull the spark plug out, wind this over, and we can see if we can get some spark out of it. I hope these threads stay in there. It's a little tight coming out. Yeah, not too bad. Alright. Now I gotta hook up my coil. Just loosely put this shroud back on here for now. And I have my kill wire unhooked here, obviously enough, the key switch is kind of messed up. And I don't know where that wire leads underneath the dash, so I'm just rather unplug it just to be safe so I don't cook anything, because these modules are really easy to cook if you're not careful. And I got the battery charger here. So let's wind it over and see what we got. If you guys can see that, We have a good spark. So that'll save me from having to convert over to points, and I have a good trigger ignition system, so I'm pretty happy about that. So let's take the shroud back off. We're going to finish cleaning out underneath it, and then we can start delving into the carburetor and the fuel system. And as you can see, this has the early style stator on it, early style Kohler stator, early style magnet, obviously enough. But it's not too bad overall, just a lot of dust and dirt and other crap, so that should clean up fairly easily. Shroud and flywheel are back on, everything went back together really nice, cleaned up good. And now we're going to start in on the carburetor, get that pulled off, and see how that looks on the inside. Still got a little bit of gas in it. Pretty bad smelling stuff, but it's still there. This is all going to need new fuel lines anyways. Most of them are all cracked and rotted. Alright, get this over to the bench, pull the bowl off, and take a look on the inside. Wow. Some pretty bad smelling stuff left in there. Definitely been sitting a while. There you have it. Nice and green. See the bowl too, hopefully. That's all full of shellac and whatnot. Pretty gooey stuff. Now if I could dry it out with some brake cleaner, it's nothing that the bead blaster can't take off, which shouldn't be too big of a problem. And as for the rest of it, depending if the float's any good, if I can get that stuff off, I get another float that I can put in it, which shouldn't be a big deal. So I'll just take this apart, get it cleaned up. If I have to, I'll run it through the blaster. If not, get it all back together with some new gaskets. For the time being right now, I'm going to hold off on the carburetor. I have it soaking in some paint thinner and acetone right now just to try to eat up some of that gum that's in it. Whether it'll help or not, can't hurt to try for a day or so. And right now I just blew out the fuel pump, so that's nice and clear. I ran some brake cleaner through it, blew out all the old gas, so obviously enough that's ready for new lines. Pull the gas tank off of it, and I took a look at the wiring. It looks like everything's original. It was just disconnected from the key switch, so that should be all be able to get hooked back up again. I might have to put new battery cables on it, which isn't too big of a deal. I can make those. I'm going to pull the plate off for the shift indicator for the hydrostatic, clean out all the mouse stuff underneath, because I can see it sticking out down below here. It's probably full to the brim from sitting all these years. Clean out the toolbox, and if I feel like it, I might pull off the belt guard also and check everything out from behind there for the parking brake and the belt tensioner and whatnot. And actually, this hydrostatic lever, it does move back and forth, and I'll show you guys when I cross that bridge. But you can see that the bracket that the pin rides on is broken, the weld broke. So that's going to have to be put back into position and welded, and I'll show you the mechanism inside on how that works when I get there. So I'll just start picking away at some stuff and see how far we can get. Belt guard's off. Belt's not actually in too bad a shape. Nothing cracked from what I could see so far, so I'll keep running this one. And there's all kinds of stuff packed in underneath the hydro pump there, so that's all going to have to get cleaned out, along with all this stuff down in here. And as you can see, this is the setup for the hydrostatic drive lever. And what it is, it's a collar with a tapered piece inside of it. And all it does is create resistance, I guess, really, is just friction. As you tighten down the spring, it makes the collar tighter, which makes it harder to push the lever forwards. But what'll happen is the tapered piece will stick inside of its receiving end, and everything jams up on this rod. And when you force it, it ends up breaking the weld on the other side, which actually happened to my 68 Charger 12. So we're going to have to pull all that apart and just re-weld the end of it, get everything cleaned up and freed up and working again, along with the parking brake, because that's a little bit sticky too. It's not moving as nicely as it should be. So I got a little bit of cleaning up to do, but not too bad though overall. So I went ahead and cleaned everything out underneath the fender pan. I got the toolbox cleaned out along with the shift area in here for the hydrostatic. And I also pulled out the shift lever and the mechanism and everything. And that was a real pain in the neck to do this morning. It took me about 2 hours with a lot of heat and a lot of penetrating oil, but I was able to get the shaft out of there, luckily. I also rebuilt the carburetor. I got that all squared away. And the 50-50 mix of acetone and paint thinner that I had it soaking in overnight definitely helped out a lot. It pretty much made the shellac that was inside of it just fall right off of all the components. Worked out really slick, so anybody who has that problem, I highly recommend doing that. Definitely saved me a lot of scraping from the other day. And right now I also have the hydrostatic lever control all taken apart, the mechanism inside. So I'll just try to explain it to you guys really quick for those of you who don't know. You just have a tapered collar on this end. The collar is keyed and rides on the shaft, which obviously bolts into place so it can't spin. And the receiving collar, the female end here, has a flat spot on it, and it rides inside of this where the handle is for the control. So as you tighten down the spring, it increases tension on the collar, makes everything a little bit tighter, so it's harder to push forward and back. Just keeps the tractor from creeping and keeps the lever stiff from moving around too much. Obviously enough, if you back the spring off, it's easier to move the lever. But the shaft was stuck inside of this piece here, and it took quite a bit of heat to get it moving again. So I just got to finish cleaning up the shaft. It's a little bit marred from me moving it around, and I also have to weld the bracket back onto the end of it, because that was the initial problem. And then I can get this handle back in the tractor, get the mechanism back together, and that'll be all squared away. Tab on the end of the rod is all welded up, and everything went together really nicely back inside now that it's all greased up and moving. As you can see, everything moves as it should, so pretty happy about that. And this is pretty much going to be it for part one, and in part two we're going to be getting this thing back together, finishing up the rest of the stuff that's going to get done to it, and we'll see if we can fire the thing up, see how she runs. So that's all for part one. There you have it, folks.